thousands of years ago in the land of Egypt. A mother put her baby in a basket and hid him in a stream among some bulrushes so that he would not be killed by the Egyptians. The baby's name was Moses. Someday he would be a great leader of his people, the Israelites, the chosen people of God. For many years, the Israelites had lived in slavery in the land of Egypt, where Pharaoh, the cruel king, forced them to work in the blazing hot sun making bricks for the pyramids. Pharaoh hated the Israelites. He said to his slave masters, "Kill all their newborn sons." And they did, all but Moses. And a strange thing happened. Moses was found by Pharaoh's own daughter, who was swimming in the stream where he'd been hidden. She loved him right away and brought him back to the palace, where he was raised like a prince.
And Moses lived at Pharaoh's court, all dressed in silver and gold. And there he grew into a man who was wise and bold. Though he was treated like a prince, he was as sad as he could be, because he knew the Israelites were held in slavery.
One day Moses was out walking in the mountains, and suddenly he saw in front of him a great flame. A bush was on fire, but the bush was not being burned up. Then he heard a voice calling to him from the burning bush. "Moses! Moses!" It was the voice of God. "I am the Lord. I have heard the cries of my people calling out to me in their hardship and sorrow. I shall deliver them from slavery, and have chosen you to lead them from Egypt to a land of their own, a land flowing with milk and honey." And Moses said, "Who am I that you should have chosen me as a leader of the Israelites? And how can a mere man lead them on this great journey alone?"
"I shall be with you," said the Lord. "Now go to Pharaoh and tell him to let my people go."
And Moses said, "But how will the Israelites know I am their leader? And what will make Pharaoh listen to me?"
"Strike your walking stick upon the ground," Moses did.
And the stick became a slithering snake.
"Now pick it up," said the Lord. Moses did.
And the snake became a stick again.
The stick became a snake. The snake became a stick. And Moses took the stick in his hand, and showed his people this sign from God, that he'd lead them to the promised land. The stick became a snake, the snake became a stick, and Moses showed the Pharaoh and said, "You'd better let my people go." But the Pharaoh only shook his head. The stick became a snake, the snake became a stick, but Pharaoh had a heart made of stone. And God said, "Now I must show this man more troubles than he's ever known." Became a snake, the snake became a stick, but Pharaoh had a heart made of stone.
And God said, now I must show this man more troubles than he's ever known. More troubles than he's ever known.
And the Lord said to Moses, hold out the stick. Moses did. And all the water in Egypt turned to blood. The fish died, and the people grew weak with thirst, but no one could drink the terrible water. Still, Pharaoh would not let the Israelites go, and Moses held out the stick again. And this time, the land was covered with frogs. And then God sent plague after plague upon the Egyptians, a plague of lice, great swarms of flies, sickness on all their animals. Still, Pharaoh would not let the people go. And God sent a plague of boils and blisters and great hailstones, locusts to eat up everything that hadn't been destroyed, and black darkness that blanketed the land for three frightful days. And through all the plagues, only the Israelites were spared. And still Pharaoh would not let them go. And finally, God sent down the angel of death, and all the firstborn sons of Egypt died. And when Pharaoh's own son died, he let the people go. The joyous Israelites were soon fleeing across the desert. As they came to the Red Sea, Moses looked back and saw the Egyptian armies chasing them in fast chariots. As the Egyptians drew closer, Moses stretched out his stick over the waters of the Red Sea. The waters divided. And with great walls of water on either side, the Israelites walked across on dry land. The chariots were right behind them. But Moses held out his stick again, and the great walls of water closed over the Egyptians, drowning them all. The Israelites knelt down and thanked God for saving them. Then, led by Moses, they continued on their journey through the wilderness toward the promised land.
Walk, wandered in the wilderness. It was quiet and lonely, nothing anywhere. And they grew weary of the wilderness, of wandering in the wilderness. But God was with them. Sent them water in the wilderness and manna to help them on their way. But sometimes weary of the wilderness, the people turned away from him and they forgot to.
Then God called Moses to the top of Mount Sinai. He said, I am the Lord your God who has brought you out of slavery in the land of Egypt. The Israelites must always believe in me and obey. And then they will be a special treasure to me, more than any other people. And here are my 10 commandments for the Israelites to follow and to bring to all the other people of the world. Thou shalt have no other gods before me.
Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image. Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain. Remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy. Honor thy father and thy mother. Thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not bear false witness against thy neighbors. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's house, nor anything that is thy neighbor. And Moses came down from Mount Sinai holding two stone tablets on which the Ten Commandments were written, and gave them to his people.
Then they walked, wandered in the wilderness, in the wilderness across the desert sand. And Moses led them through the wilderness, until at last he led them to the promised land.